Hello, I'm Claudia Zeiske. I'm the Director of Deveron Projects in Huntley. Today I will tell you how we work in our town. On the bottom of each slide you find our logo, the town is the venue. It is our mantra. Here we use existing spaces instead of an art center or building. On the other side you find 50-50. Half art and half community, half hospitality and half criticality, half local, half global, and so on. This conundrum needs always to be in balance. If a project is a great art production but does not touch the community, it is not a good project for us. Likewise, if a project is loved by the community but does not bring on the arts, it is not a successful project for us. We need to always think and work hard to make this balance possible. This is Huntley from outside. And this is Huntley from inside. It is our gallery and our art center from outside and from inside. The weather is not always bad here. Here you see Huntley Square during the annual Hearst Food and Farming Festival. Huntley is a historic market town in Aberdeenshire. It has about 4,500 people and serves a hinterland of another 4,500 people. Its center is an 18th century conservation area. However, globalization trends have hit Huntley hard in recent years. While two large supermarkets sprang up, the banks and the tourist information center have closed. The post office moved into a small newsagent. Many shops have closed. The town center looks in decline. So we decided to take things into our own hands. But before I tell you how we do this, I want to introduce you to Patrick Geddes. Patrick Geddes was born in Aberdeenshire. He was a biologist, an architect, and a community planner, a true polymath. His mantra was the triptych place, work, folk. If all of those are in equilibrium, he said, then we have a good life, a good family, a good community. And therefore, with all of those being in a good state, we would have a good world. Patrick Geddes also coined the phrase, think globally, act locally. And this philosophy is the starting point for all our projects. I'm going to tell you now about some of the projects we have done over the past 25 years with almost 100 artists from all over the world. Let me start with the project Empty Shop, which we undertook in 2004 with Danish artist Eva Mertz, who herself comes from a shopkeeper's family in Jutland. Empty Shop is a project on the loss of rural shopping facilities. Eva hired with her material allowance one of the many empty shops in Huntley. She used it as a studio and then declared it as the first empty shop monument in Britain. It was drawing on the nostalgic sentiments we have about small-scale shops in the era of large supermarkets, out-of-town retail centers, and internet shopping. She created a kind of fake tourist attraction with empty shop posters, mugs, firelighters, empty shop fridge magnets, and other memorabilia normally sold as souvenirs. Another project drew on the lack of cycle paths in our town. Glasgow-based artist Jacqueline Donaghy created a slowdown project where she, over the period of 3 months, mobilized many Huntley citizens to learn how to cycle and how to fix bikes. She created a bicycle amnesty where people donated broken bikes. They were fixed and made available to the community. During this time, she also researched an ideal cycle route of 8 kilometers in our town. The project culminated in a slowdown day where we closed the town center to car traffic. Have a look at the upside down plastic bottles fixed to all the bikes. They were filled with colored chalk and fitted with a small brush. On slowdown day, some 350 people all cycled the 8 kilometer route. Even the police was on a bicycle. People drew the cycle path with their bottle chalk devices. The next day, the rain came and washed it all away again. We often also work with the history of the town. James Gordon was a 17th century cartographer who was the first person who drew Scotland. He did this for the Bleu Atlas that was published in Amsterdam. We invited Spanish artist Maida Lopez to create a contemporary reaction to Gordon's legacy. Her project was called How Do You Live This Place? A community mapping initiative. For this, she painted many, many stones in primary colors. Blue meant I love this place, red meant I hate this place, yellow meant I have good memories of this place, and so on. One Saturday in winter, people picked up those stones, one color each, and walked around the town to place their stones. Here's the library with a mix of sentiments. The community bookshop has more positive colors. When people got back to the square, they were given stickers in the same colors to place on a large map. This allowed us to find out what people think about our town, about the good, the bad, and the ugly, so to speak, of our place. As you can see, our projects are really about bringing people together through all kinds of means. This gave us some buy-in from the local community over the years. There was one big issue that people had with our place. Our town was branded at some point by consultants the family town. People did not like this for a number of reasons. So they gathered money and asked us to work with an artist who would create a new branding that people would buy in. We jointly invited South African artist Jack Hutzer. His starting point was that Huntley's identity is not made up of one singular element. It was also rooted geographically, built where the two rivers, the Bogie and the Deveron, flow together. Once the various nodes are connected, they form a whole branch. The template could be applied to other fields. For example, the subcultures within Huntley, architecture, sport, culture, but also the different kind of people, young people, older people, migrants. They all are important beyond the idea and the concept of a family. The recurring pattern resembles the very iconic form of a deer's antler. The symbol of the antler was included in Huntley's former coat of arms, as well as in local institutions, such as Huntley's Football Club or the Gordon Highlanders Regiment. The contemporary new design created by the artist reflects the Scottish antler, a roadmap, social diversity, growth and energy within our place. But the artist also formed an anthem for the town. For this, he was inspired by the poem Room to Roam, written by Huntley's prime poet, George MacDonald, in 1858. This poem was picked up by the Scottish pop band The Waterboys for their like-named album. To work on this, Jacques invited the band's leader, Mike Scott, to come to Huntley and form a choir. Here you see the Room to Roam choir. The artist stands in the back and Mike Scott is in the front with his guitar. The choir only sings this one song, Room to Roam, Huntley's town anthem. I thought of normally singing it to you, but I'm not sure whether it works for this presentation. Today, the travelers see a sign, Huntley Room to Roam, as they come into the town on the A96 trunk road. The previous sign, Huntley Family Town, is no longer there. Moving on, almost 10 years of doing projects of social, environmental, health, and other concerns that unearth the identity of our place, we have now decided to undertake more long-term projects. Following the UK referendum decision to leave the EU, we launched a three-year program called Think Brexit, which existed of many different elements, including monthly Brexfests, discussing the local implications of Brexit on, for example, education, health, art, tourism, business, etc. in our place. Think Brexit culminated in the planting of a weeping willow to to mark the historic day with Berlin-based artist Clemens Wilhelm. Many local people walked in a procession to a specially chosen site on the River Deveron. A stone was sited to mark 31st of January 2020, the historic day when the UK left the European Union. Art impresario Richard DeMarco came to do this with us alongside six tree guardians from the community who promised to look after the tree. Here you see myself sitting at the site the next day. We have also been running a number of long-term programs. One of them is The Town is the Garden with Joss Allen. The Town is the Garden is a community growing scheme which discusses our food culture and re-educates people in how to grow their own food locally. Events included a garden doctor scheme, workshops on bread making, foraging and kombucha making, tree grafting sessions, and much, much more. When the project finished, its legacies are a local seed library, a community orchard, a Huntley climate group, a local food plan, and a physical library with books on all things growing. This led to a new venture that we set up with artist chef Kauthay Louie. She comes from Iraq. The new Neep and Okra kitchen is a locally sourced, globally inspired hospitality project. It's a meeting point between locality, migration and well-being through an environmentally sensitive program of cooking, gardening and eating together. Only locally grown food is being used, however, always enhanced by global spices. As you can see, unlike with other art organizations, the community and its concerns are always the starting point for our projects. The butcher, the baker, and the artist are equally important in our form of working with the place. And while we will always be loyal to our Town is the Venue mantra, we now bought a building. It is one of the empty shops on the town square, which you saw at the beginning of this presentation. Together with other groups in the community, we have decided to take the fate of our town into our own hands and bring the town center into community ownership. Here you see us with our board, our staff, our artists, and some of our volunteers. We are looking forward to a very positive future of our town center. If you find our work interesting, you might like to get the book Artocracy that I have written with curator Nuno Sacramento. It is a handbook of how to do it all and easy to read with loads of hands-on tips. Thank you for listening. Much more can be found on our website. We hope to see you there, or maybe sometime in person in our bonny town of Huntley.